It's the story of Pandora's box.
Where'd they come from?
I don't know.
Should we tell them a story?
About gods and mortals?
Where Pandora, one of like the humans, opens this box that's filled with all of the bad things in the world, like illness.
I pulled my hamstring.
In Greek mythology.
Well, evil lies in the world. Who will rise against it?
And we're all on this marble that hurtles through space. Our orbits and paths are unique.
The level ones in theater, they opened up with this fog machine and they had like the face paint, glowing face paint, and like the black light. It was phenomenal. That was like a great way to start and open the showcase.
So we were narrators during the entire show, and at the beginning we were gods who were explaining the first beginning of the story.
If there was land and sea, there was no discernible shoreline. You had to walk on one or swim or sail on the other.
It was so much fun. Before the show, we got to play with a lot of glow-in-the-dark makeup. We learned a lot of different techniques on how to do makeup, and it was so cool seeing it in the black light and how it was shown on stage.
But upwards to the sky in pride, or perhaps nostalgia.
We were this like the start of life, and then Prometheus, he like gave us the fire.
Prometheus cannot stand idly by as humans live without the heat and light of fire.
We have the dance, but now you have to tell the story. So you can, I personally think you can put any dance move, but it's the emotion you put in it that tells the story.
There was this one moment in our dance where we all like come together and find ways to connect to one another, and we like move like a wave. That was really hard for us to figure out, but in the end, I think it went really smoothly.
Sang a song from Tangled called I See the Light. It's after when Pandora opens the box and the hope comes out and everyone's finally seeing the light. That's what our piece is supposed to represent. We have these movable pieces, like little boards that stand up on the stage that cover up the harp before the harp player plays it. I think it's what makes our piece unique to the other ones, though. We may not have had vocal solos, but we at least had the flute solo and the harp solo in the middle.
I'm waiting, 'cause that's what we do here.
Musical theater too. I really like their song. That's my favorite part.
I don't know to happen, you know, just something different to happen. Just waiting for something to change, just a change.
Their song is, it's about Hades waiting, one of the gods waiting. Their song is like super catchy. And that's also the dance is like really, it's much more coordinated than ours. It's they have a lot of really good vocal soloists as well.
We did a
a piece called Hope, and we portrayed the last thing that came out of Pandora's box. And it was a piece that represented how we all come together almost as a community. We were portraying almost the demons, and then there were two people having a duet, and one person was Faith and one person was Pandora. So when we came up on the stage, we were interacting with them. We were kind of almost like retracting to the light, and then you saw us kind of pause, and that was Pandora's moment of like, everything's okay, we're gonna find hope, we're gonna find faith.
Our piece was fairly abstract. We didn't have a big storyline, but we had a theme. And our theme was essentially, without other people with us to define our lives don't mean much at all. And we define our lives by other people.
A voice that is yearning to fly, but the terrain is unpredictable. Complex mysteries here. There are paradoxes here to undo.
And by the end of the piece, we're in this tight, like, clump, as we call them, and there's a sense of community in there for us.
And it's you on this marble, hurtling through space, with a path just as thoughtful and wise. I stand here beside you, and I look in your face, and I see myself in your eyes.
I loved Theater Level 4's piece, they did Aristicton. Something about how they portrayed everything, it was really good.
We need the wood, cut it down. Sir, this is a sacred grove, and this tree is beloved by Ceres. It's only a tree the goddess likes. Ceres is a goddess herself, I cut it down just the same. Sir, please, get your hands off me!
And he tore the tree down.
Well, we had kind of joked, like, oh, you're going to be playing a tree. But, like, then you really, like, it's a sacred tree. So then they, like, get into, like, positions. And we're like, okay, what can really make this tree, like, a sacred, lively tree? We told the story of Aristicton with, like, hunger. And he's, like, a greedy king. I played hunger. And hunger kind of, like, crawls onto him and makes him devour himself.
Anything! I'm starving! But he cannot wait to be served! He begins to eat everything meal after meal after meal! But his hunger is not plenished. I need more!
It's intense to just like have to be piggyback riding on someone the whole time. It's intense for him to be lifting me the whole time. It's a lot of balance. And then like at some point he like goes down onto his knees and then he has to get back up. So like it took a lot of rehearsing to try and get the lifts correct and to get them to like a safe point.
I am in visual arts level 4, and I have a short film. It's called Maybe Next Time. It turned out pretty good. I had a lot of good feedback from a lot of my peers and a lot of parents too that came up to me, and they were saying that the film was very beautiful and they can't wait to see what I have next.
The level ones, we got to pick between one of the major projects that we did in the first marking period, and I chose the Arkandinsky project, which is an abstract and non-representational piece that has 5 or more layers and is multimedia. The level 3s, their self-portraits were amazing. They were so good. And also the level 2s did wearable art. Those were also very good.
I think just like having these visual arts students like being able to tap into their like creative factors was like really, really amazing.
It was a really cool experience to be able to like walk into this room that's normally like mostly empty whenever you go in there and see like all of these different works of art and like being able to be a part of that too. It's kind of like reassuring to me. I'm like, oh my God, I'm doing this. Like, I'm actually a part of this, and it's really cool.
It feels really good to be with so many people, and like some I know, some I don't know. And it's just like, it's the end. You feel like accomplished and you feel really good about yourself.
As we lean forward together with hope, we know the journey's better.
All the seniors in dance had to choreograph a 2/8 count solo. And while theater was doing a spoken word, we came out and we had to do something like kind of impressive. It kind of gives the seniors a moment to spotlight because it was the seniors that did the little dance pieces, and it was me and my other senior classmates doing the speaking parts. And the dancing with the MT kids, it kind of gives a little bit of a moment for the seniors to like shine, but still involve everybody.
Knowing that every time I do something nice, it gives me more hope for the future.
The finale is personally, I thought it was very impressive. It was just like everyone together. I've never performed with that amount of people before.
We haven't done something like that since my freshman year, and I don't know, just being a senior, it's really weird to look back on what we've done in the past, and to have every level in the same place at the same time for the first time since is, it's a really, like, there's a lot of energy in that moment.